Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of DooM. So, today we are going to be pushing into the reactor core here and trying to prevent a meltdown. If you remember, the science lady was who's leading the cult is trying to blow this place to Kingdom Come, I guess. So we need to stop her, because we gotta kill these dudes. So, we're gonna go ahead and get this arena going here. This is a pretty cool one. Try out our new gun, which is pretty cool. I really like it a lot better with the upgrades, just because the projectiles travel a little bit slow, but that's okay. I mean, not every single one can be a winner. The plasma rifle has the upgrade that I actually really like, which is it's kind of like an AoE discharge thing, where like the gun heats up while you're using it, and then it like you can discharge it by right-clicking it anytime, and it does like an AoE shockwave that shoots out of you with tons of damage. That one's really good, and I think it also has a kind of grenade launcher type thing, which it seems like a lot of guns do. Which maybe we'll try that on this playthrough since I haven't seen it before. Ooh, okay. And Hell Knight is this Hell Knight is not playing around. Get him out of here. Shoot, and we gotta try to remember if we see soldiers that we want to, there's a certain way we need to kill them. I think it's death from above, but let's, double check our challenge log here. Yes, 3 death from above on the possessed soldiers. So, those are the guys who have the guns. Crack some of these guys down and wipe them out. Yeah, there's one. Sweet. Okay. So, push our way up here. And see if we can't get this challenge done. Come on. Okay. Yes. Okay. 1 down. 2 to go. Wait. Did we not get it? Is there like a different way I need to do it? Gosh darn it. Is that not the curb stomp move? I thought it was. You'd think that the like jumping on them and smushing their head would be. Maybe you have to like trip them? Let's try on this guy again. Or is this not... Oh wait. This is not a possessed soldier, I think, is the problem. This is gosh, I can't remember what they're called. That's the weird dude. Is that a possessed soldier? Yeah. No. We're not getting served any of the guys we need. That's okay. We'll just, kite this guy in circles for a minute here. And, oh god, we need your help. Oh, we're down! God dang it. Alright. Let's try that again. Maybe be a little bit more tactical and stop trying to get these glory kills, since apparently we can't get a soldier to spawn for the life of us. So, let's try that one more time. And, let's just go with a really powerful gun right off the bat, which is this guy. Gotta love it. Okay. So, we want to run around here and grab all these power-ups, actually, before the Hell Knights come in, because we need the armor. Is that a soldier? No. None of these guys are soldiers. Lots of imps, though. Let's jump up here and get the high ground and see if we can make use of our scope. Oh, nope, we can't. Alright, come on down, big boy. Boom. Yeah, these guys are like, you know, usually I'm an advocate of killing the smaller dudes and then going for the big guys last, but these Hell Knights you have to really focus on because they don't fuck around, they will just drop you. But they're a great opportunity for a glory kill because they usually give a good amount of health and ammo. Come back here. Boom. You know, I was listening to a podcast today, and people were saying, like, a lot of people are against the glory kill system. They say it's, like, not doomy enough, which I don't get. I've played all the Doom games, and Melee, I feel like, has always been a pretty fun part of it, but there's been, like, a bit of an issue where it doesn't quite stack up to the gunplay. And I feel like here, they've really integrated it in a great way, and I really like the way that it heals you. I think it's a great replacement for having to run around and pick up health fragments. Like, the armor is enough for me. I think having, like, uninterrupted flow of combat is way more important to me than using only ranged weapons. I don't really get it. Especially because I played Brutal Doom a lot. The awesome... If you haven't seen it, it's amazing. Like, you can get Doom for almost nothing nowadays, so pick up Doom or emulate it or whatever. And, oh gosh, I don't know where to download it now, because isn't Filefront gone? Maybe on ModDB? See if you can find the Brutal Doom mod. It's awesome. Somebody completely redid the original game with, like, a modern first-person style control system and stuff, so you actually can look up and, like, actually you aim with a reticle and all that, and, like, it has 3D particle effects. It's super cool. But a big part of that game is that you have melee execution kills that are super awesome, and I feel like that's kind of maybe part of where this came from, and I feel like it's fitting. I really do, just like I thought it was fitting in that mod. Brutal Doom, by the way, if seriously, check it out if you haven't. It's, you can get it for next to nothing, so. And the mod itself is free. Okay, I think it actually works on Doom and Doom 2, now that I think about it, which is great. That's, I love that Doom has so many mods. I was actually, you know, another thing I heard, I think on the Bombcast this week, they were saying that, there's no planned mod support for this game, which is a pretty big bummer. Like, that's a missed opportunity. I don't think they've publicly stated there won't be support, but they have not, like, when people have asked them if there will be, they will not give a straight answer. Like, I think the implication was they were hoping Snap Map would be enough. We haven't checked out Snap Map yet. It's their custom game mode thing, and it's pretty cool. I've played a few rounds of it myself, and we'll check it out later on, but I really don't think it quite fills, it comes anywhere near the potential that players have developed, like, for mods, even in just something like Skyrim before the mod toolkit came out. So, I don't know. Okay, this is the one, I think. What the heck outfit is she even wearing?
She is trying to tear open the portal between our world and theirs.
Oh, snap. Hell on Mars. So, for those who don't know, this is something that I think happened in the first Doom, where at the end of it, Earth and Hell start merging. That might be in the second one, I'll be honest. I get them mixed up just because they are, like, on the same engine and look very similar. But, or I think they're on the same engine. But you get some really cool levels where Hell and Earth are fused. So who knows? Maybe, who knows if we'll actually succeed in stopping her. But if we don't, it'd be pretty cool to see some maybe half Hell, half Mars type landscapes. Because the graphics in this game are fantastic. So, they could do some real, there's some real potential there. They could do some good. Chase her down! We'll never catch her, because she's walking slowly. We'll never catch this slow old woman.
We will have to shut down the Argent Tower manually from the surface.
Shut up, Wayland. And once again, we continue my streak of getting one secret. Also, we failed to do one, we only got one challenge done. That's okay, we got 4 out of 5 for our combat pips. So we should actually upgrade a gun here, because we have probably a ton of gun upgrade points that we've just kind of been banking. I was used to, in my other playthrough, going a really, really long time without getting any upgrades, just because the later upgrades cost exponentially more than the early ones. So you get to the point where you're spending 7 or 8 for a single upgrade. So it takes a level or two to be able to spend anything. Ooh, more floaty ashes. I really like this little load effect.
Olivia is using the tower to drill a doorway into their world. You can prevent her from opening the gate by disabling the tower induction filters.
Oh, we will. It always cracks me up when I see the guns that are, like, laying just around, like, over here just now. Just because sometimes I wonder if those are backup guns, because in a lot of these games back in the day, like Serious Sam and stuff like that, you can get guns out of order or early by completing little side puzzles and stuff. And this game seems like it fits the bill for that, so I wonder if, like, you can miss points where even I've seen it where it just seems like it's right in front of you, but people can just walk right past it, and they just want to give it to you so you don't miss out. Okay, this will be a fun arena. We're back on the surface here. Do a little bit of sniping. Get out of here, zombie guy. Yeah, this is pointless from here. Wow. Boy, am I missing that double jump. Soon enough, my friends, soon enough. Alright, let's see what is down here. Ooh, jeez, that was close. Just jumped right over the ledge. Alright, so. Lots of parkour, that's what's up. Thank goodness for these green lights. Always telling you where to go. Oh, unless... Oh, yeah. Wait. Oh, do we jump back across here? Seriously. Single jumping is... feels so inefficient. I hope we're going the right way. Yes, okay. Oh, awesome. So this is our first... what are these called? Rune trial. So this is like the... kind of like the Trials of the Rakyat in Far Cry. Basically, it's a sweet little mini combat arena where we are going to be trying to fulfill a certain... some kind of objective within a time limit, and we get runes, which are equipable passive upgrades that are totally sweet. So, hopefully we can go ahead and get increased range on absorbing dropped items. Vacuum, that's a great one. So we gotta get 15 shotgun kills in 10 seconds, but we get 2 seconds per kill or 4 seconds per glory kill. Oh, I actually didn't know you got more for glory kills. I assumed less, because it's not really a shotgun kill. So, let's just destroy these dudes. Get out of here. I killed 15. I shouldn't have gone for this guy. He's really too far away. Get some of that glory time. Boom. More glory time. This is the first one, so I'm sure it's like they give you plenty of time. Some of the later ones, though, they really, like, you're down to the second. It's pretty rough. Some of the, like, there's, like, a parkour one where you have better control over your midair, like, movement. And that one, you get, like, a second spare. You can't make a single mistake on, like, a parkour course in this game, which is kind of hilarious. All right, so we did it. Because shotgunning imps is what I do. So now we can go ahead and equip this once we get out of here, and we will be able to pick up armor and, or well, I don't know about armor, but certainly dropped health and ammo from much further away range. In fact, now we don't have to chase it at all as long as we have this one equipped, which we will for a while probably. Also, these have a little bit of an RPG element to them. They can be upgraded just by fulfilling another little objective for this. Absorb dropped items, usually just by using them or whatever they buff, you can fill them in, and this I think extends the range even more when you upgrade it. Oh, and I promised that we would, we need to do some upgrades. We have a ridiculous number of points. All right, so I think, do we want to go ahead? Oh, we still need a drone. So we can upgrade our tactical scope. Bullets fired while zoomed in penetrate through targets. Ooh, additional headshot damage. Ooh, move faster when zoomed. And then once you get all three of these, which you can get in any order, this unlocks once you fulfill usually like a small objective. This will make ammunition fired when zoomed do heavy damage rounds, I guess. Okay, that's cool. We could just upgrade the crap out of our explosive shot, which would be pretty fun. Ooh, which it can create child bombs. That's pretty neat. Or we can also upgrade our pistol, actually, but I don't use the pistol very much. I think I really want to just do, I want this uranium coating, and I want this skullcracker, and we can get one more upgrade. Let's do big boom for a larger explosion radius on our shotgun. Cool. And we also have some armor upgrades, and I'm going to put 2 points right away into dexterity. This is going to make it so we can switch weapons faster, because I like to switch a lot in combat, and it's very helpful in a pinch. And then lastly, we have 1 point left over. Let's put it into power-up effectiveness. This gives an AoE blast wave when when a power-up runs out, which is okay. This is what I care about more, full health when you pick up a power-up, or more time when you're using one, because the power-ups in this are so good, and they're often tied to challenges, so having that extra time can make a big difference if you have to, like, say, get 20 quad damage kills, and you want to make sure that you can actually do that with the existing power-ups, because once you use them, the timer goes, and then they're gone. They don't respawn. And there we go. I think that's our second one so far, where I just jump right off a ledge. That map awareness, jeez. We saw it in Overwatch, we're gonna see it here. You'll see it in pretty much every first-person game that I play because I just lack depth perception, I guess. I don't know. Alright, so, or situational awareness. I don't know, I don't remember once I turn around. It'll just strafe right off. So, grab any ammo we can. Do we even need to go over here? There's a light there, but maybe a secret? I really don't want to, I don't want to die again. Okay. It seems like there's a secret here, but I guess not. Maybe you were just supposed to come up this side and then jump across this way? Whatever. Okay, so, let's keep pushing forward. Gonna be some dudes here soon, I'm sure. Hey. Do you guys not spawn in on this anymore? In Doom 3, they were all about having them spawn in on pentagrams. Oh, you guys. That's a rocket launcher. Time to have some fun. This has always been one of my favorite weapons in any arena type shooter. I don't think you can rocket jump with this one, I'll be honest, but you don't really need to. What you can do is massive amounts of damage. We just killed like 6 guys with that shot. Oh, we should check and see what our... Ooh, sorry, I opened the console by accident. We should check and see. So we need... Oh, we've already interacted with the Rune Trial Stone. We need to get the auto map for the Argent facility, let's not forget, and then perform 2 death from above glory kills on Hell Knights. Okay, that we need to make sure we try to do. because that's not something that'll happen just by accident. Some of these, it's nice. You'll actually get them before you even, you'll complete them before you even knew it was an objective, like that trial. Ooh. Get out of here with that. Maybe that's a curb stomp kill? I'm not exactly sure what all the different... I should look it up. I'm not exactly sure what all the different ways you can approach an enemy to trigger the different glory kill animations are. I don't even know how many animations there are. So far, I think I know four or five, because it seems like there's a couple for each. But I know front, behind, left, right, and above all trigger different types of animations. I swear there's an imp, like... No, there they are. I was like, I thought there was one, like, right behind me. Boom! Oh, wait. We don't want that. We want to try out our new... Ooh, okay, so this Hell Knight, we want to kill him near some high ground, so or at least down him, so that we can do the death from above. Yes, like this. Boom! Alright. 1 out of 2. We got to be careful, because those guys are... It can be really dangerous trying to kill them in a very special way, just because messing around like that, they can just end you. I hope this is the right way. Feel like this was the wrong way. This was definitely the wrong way. You guys, I am very sorry. And if that was the right way, then I'm double sorry, because now I'm backtracking. But, oh, and, ugh, you guys. Okay, let's go back up here as fast as we can. Sorry about that. Again, my situational awareness, not so good. And I can't read the maps in this game. So what are you going to do? All right, across here. And then I think we ignore the stairs and grab all these sweet power-ups that we missed before somehow. Yeah. No secret, though. I would have loved a DooM Marine. One of the little collectible guys. Those guys are sweet. And I think they unlock, like, not concept art, but, like, 3D models you can look at. Which seems to be a trend in games nowadays. Doesn't Battlefront has, like, a diorama mode? It all reminds me of Smash Brothers trophies. Which some of those were really cool back in the day, but that's because they had, like, deep cuts. Like, they'd have, like, ridiculous old-school Nintendo references. And then they added in the, what are they called, assist trophy things in combat, and that kind of filled in a lot of that coolness just in the actual matches, which was nice. I don't play as much Smash now, but, that's a great game. Okay. I think we want to go back this way. Haha, yes. Alright, and a drone, so... we gotta go hunt it down. Alright, okay, so it goes down there, and we can't forget because that is not the way we need to go. However, we're out of ammo, but this is an ammo box. I don't know if we've run into one of these before. They don't really tell you about them, but, you can punch them, and they're full of ammo. So now we have max ammo with our rocket launcher, and we can approach this however we want. So I think what we'll do is use this guy to just move in here and pick a couple guys off. Man, this gun is, like... really echoey and loud. Okay, here we go. Now we gotta play serious. Okay, good. We were getting a little low on health there for my taste. Alright. My watchword is not to get cocky this time. Alright, so we want to try and kill this guy again with a kill from above. So if we can knock him down right next to this pillar thing, we can... Yes, perfect. Aha! Done. Alright, so that's that mission completed. Now all we gotta do is remember to grab that auto map when we're in that, what is it? Argent Temple? What's the Scarlet Monastery? We just gotta go to the library and pick up the auto map? Sounds good. Whoa! I know we completed the mission, but again, don't get cocky. Ooh, that was a good one. Alright. Oh, we don't need to do it anymore. I was thinking, we needed to curb stomp these guys still, but no. Alas, we've already failed that mission. What a heartbreaking experience that was. Done. Alright, so let's not forget... Ooh, we got a weapon upgrade point. I'm sure there's secrets in here, so we'll peek around as well. But first, I want to grab that drone before we completely whiff on it. It's right down here. You have to kind of go around a bend. Armor. Ooh. See, I don't use my chainsaw enough. We got chainsaw ammo right there. Okay, so, do we upgrade? It's gotta be the rocket, right? And last time I got the lock-on burst, it's okay, but remote detonation, I mean, come on. I really should have gotten that in the first place. So we're gonna make it so we can basically right-click at any time that a rocket's in the air, and it will detonate it at that moment. So watch. Fire. Explodes midair without hitting anything. Awesome. That is gonna be a lot of fun, although I don't necessarily think I need it, because, I don't know, I feel like I'm okay with rockets in these kinds of games, but I mean, it can only help, right? So this seems like it would lead to a secret. Yeah? Or maybe this is just the way you go. Yep, just the way you go. Bummer. Ah, well. At least we don't have to wander around trying to figure out what to do next. Oh, snap. Boom. Get out of here. Get right the F out of here. Yes, okay. Hell Knight's everywhere all of a sudden. Wow, this isn't too bad. It's going to be really bad when the Kako demons start coming. They're like giant. I believe those are the one that's the name of the... Oh, sorry, Siren. I believe that's the name of the one that's the giant, like, floating head. Okay, we gotta be way more careful. Let's grab this armor. And please don't die. Okay, yes, okay, good. That was a close one. Now to 4 HP. Got a little tense there for a moment. Oof, we gotta still take it easy, though. Is that health? Yes, and it's just flying to us. Thank goodness. I like that vacuum rune. Weird delay there. Get out of here. Alright. Double glory kill. Always cool. Got a weapon upgrade point again, but we're gonna bank it for now. Because I would like to get the... I think it costs 5 to get the next one I want, or maybe 7. I want the, full movement speed when zoomed. Oh, I can't decide. I really like this gun a lot, and I kind of like upgrading it, but maybe I want to upgrade my rocket launcher next. Ooh, boy. That guy snuck up right behind me. Scared the crap out of me. Get out of here. We get all the upgrades for when we're zoomed in and we're just firing from the hip. Oh, yeah, that bonus headshot damage is nice. Oh, I bet that's really good against Hell Knights and stuff, too. I should keep that in mind. Who's hiding in here waiting for me? I know you're in here somewhere. Wait. We need to get all the way across there, so we want to go around, I think. Or up? No, around. And we've continued to miss all kinds of secrets. Ooh, okay, let's not miss that, because that appears to be optional, but that is another rune trial, and we want to unlock as many of these. Ooh, how do we get up there? We want to unlock as many of these as we can, as fast as we can, because they give... once you unlock 4, you can have 2 equipped at a time, and then I don't know how many more you have to do to unlock the rest, or a third, but being able to have multiple is nice. Increases how long demons remain in stagger mode. That's, like, super OP and awesome, but I think I actually prefer the vacuum ability, just because you can suck everything in without having to even think about it. Armed with the pistol, destroy 30 barrels before the timer expires? Really? Maybe this is gonna be harder than it seems, because it seems like it's gonna be, like... easiest thing. Get 2 seconds per one destroyed? What is this? Joke? This gun has infinite ammo and doesn't reload. I guess actually time is kind of flying by and I'm running out of barrels to shoot, but still seems a little bit compared to some of the other ones I've done. I guess this is still in the first level that introduced the trials though. Oh, it marks the rest for you. How nice of it. Okay, so that was surprisingly easy. Cool. So we got another rune. 2 more to go until we can have 2 equipped at a time. And some of them are super good, not like increased stagger time. Although, really, that is quite good because you can just use that to take multiple guys out of the fight at once and then restore a ton of health in one fell swoop. All right, so back to the level again. Let's go ahead and try and complete this objective. We gotta stop her from ripping open the hell portal. Did I mention that I love these doors because it's not a quick time event? If I did, I'm just gonna say it again, so sorry if you listened to the last time, but seriously, thank you so much for not making those doors completely unnecessary quick time events. That would be extremely frustrating. I don't know how... Is this just for the ammo in here? And I guess there's a rocket launcher if you didn't get it before? I don't know. I'm not super clear on where we're supposed to be going right now. We can't go through there. There's nowhere to go through. Okay, so this is just a dead end. Let's go back around this corner. And there's an objective over there, and there's one that's like right here. I think it's probably up there, but how... God, I get turned around in this crap so easily. I think if we just go back, double back on this, then we can cross there. Or, what's this? Ooh, armor upgrade. Glad I checked it out. I was totally just gonna be lazy and not say anything when I first saw it. Okay, so now we got another Praetor token, which we're gonna hold on to because most of the good upgrades now are gonna cost 2 or 3 even. I'd like to get the dexterity that increases ledge climb speed. Because you do a lot of that in combat. Maybe that's not how you get up there? Maybe you were supposed to climb up onto this barge and, like, jump across? Does that make sense? No, we can't even get through there. Come on, game. Oh, okay. I'll probably just go through these doors, and I bet there's stairs. I almost hope it's more complicated. Nope. It's not even stairs. Okay.
We're only temporarily disabling the tower. You need to remove each lens individually. Carefully release the hinges.
Yeah, DooM guy. He's too metal to carefully release hinges. So, DooM guy ain't having none of it. He's basically like throwing the baby out with the bathwater. We don't want your futuristic hell power, even if it is powering Earth right now. It's all evil. You're all evil. And I feel like he's kind of in the right here. See, this is again what I'm talking about. There's just like a chainsaw. Maybe it's just a creative way to give you ammo, and I just never use my ammo. That seems like the most likely thing. Okay, so looks like we have an objective right over here, and then we'll go to that far away one after. But is there a door we can go through? Do we have to go downstairs or something? Okay, here we go. I feel like we've been here before, but honestly, these environments start to look the same. Okay, well, this is not the objective, but I'm really glad we came back here. Look at that. This is one of the Argent Energy upgrades. Boom. So, I say we upgrade our ammo again, because I like to upgrade ammo. Boom. Yes. Cool, cool, cool. So now we have 180 rounds with this thing. That's what I'm talking about. We can actually use it for a semi-extended period. Now, I'm guessing that's all that's in here, though. Except, that's green, which means you can climb up here. Which means maybe a secret? Yep, or maybe this is just the way you're supposed to go. More likely, I suppose. Yeah, looks like this is just the right way. What is that? It's nothing. Okay, I think we're on the right track again. What's over here? Actually, we should go to this. It's closer. Sorry, guys. Getting all turned around and going in circles a little bit here, just trying to figure out what the best course of action is. I think if we go back in here, there's an objective that we're, like, right on top of. And we've been in here multiple times. Did I just miss it before? It's right there. Sorry.
The hell energy is unusable without the filters.
Screw you. Tell me to beware. Tell you where to be. Out my face.
It's more valuable than you can possibly imagine. It is a perfect and unlimited energy resource.
Well, that's great. But so am I. Boom. I think if we go back down this way, we can get to this last objective. Yes, okay, cool. Anybody waiting for us? No? There we go. I knew it. Just the one? I wonder what he was doing, just straggling behind everybody else. Okay, so let's just destroy this last one immediately and then clear everybody out. Yes. Oops, first if we can, just because those fireballs really do add up. And I guess as soon as we really see a Hell Knight, we're going to have to deal with that. Oh! You guys, I fell off a ledge again. I feel like this time it wasn't totally my fault, though, right? Because, like, normally it's like, come on, dude. Like, that, you saw that, you looked at it, you turned around, and then backed into it. But in this case, like, I didn't even know that there was anywhere to fall into here. Okay, so, let's try that one more time. Ooh, nope, already got it. We are going to try and be a little more strategic, too. Let's use this right off the bat and try and use our scope to get some easy kills since we have all the bonus. Now we have piercing rounds and bonus headshot damage when we're scoped in. Like, that's pretty cool. One bullet to kill an imp. I'm down with that. Though I do have to admit I kind of miss micro-missiles sometimes. It doesn't look like there's any demons in here at all until we destroy the nest, which is kind of weird. Whoa. Yeah, see, we're doing really good damage against those guys, and they have a ton of armor. But we gotta be. Okay, so, shield soldier. God dang it. All right. Stop trying to be clever. Stop trying to be efficient with damage. Just go into the arena mode and lose yourself. I may have to focus here for a second. This is the arenas are starting to get real. Make sure we don't miss anything again. And there's probably something up there if I haven't gone up already, but I really just want to complete these objectives already. Come here, guy. What? I shot him in the head. That was ridiculous. Nope. Definitely want to keep the... Oh, we should... Yeah, let's make sure we're using this grenade launcher attachment. Because that is really, really helpful against larger groups. Also, actually, a better grenade launcher is... Oh, no. I almost jumped in there again. The rocket launcher. As long as we don't get too close. Low health already. Okay, let's not use the rocket launcher because I don't want to die. Ooh, no. Hell Knight on us, but this soldier is a huge pain. Okay, we got the soldier. Hell Knight almost knocked us off the ledge. We are super close to death. Gotta kill this. Yes, okay, go on, kill. Alright, keep moving. So, this is what I was saying earlier, though, about how the level design here is just fantastic. We've got jump pads. We've got these awesome original arenas that you fight here one time. Awesome. So this is the haste power-up that doubles your speed and your attack speed and reload speed. It doubles the speed, I think. But yeah, I really like this arena design, and it's like you're here once, but the level design is so good that like I almost hope this is a multiplayer map just because it's just a great round, like easy to navigate with multiple angles you can come at arena. The jump pads is an especially nice touch. Oh, and we can even go down here. I didn't even notice. Actually, this level kind of reminds me of the original Arkham Asylum level design, like Mr. Freeze areas. Alright. Another one bites the dust. Checkpoint reached. Is that all of them then? Let's make sure we don't miss any awesome power-ups or obvious Argent energy buffs. This seems like a destination that we need to go to, but maybe it's just a sweet secret. Yeah, see, this feels almost a little bit too much like we're making progress. And you know how I feel about making progress when I want to find secrets, guys. Ah, well. Now we got dudes to fight. So apparently there's also a relic that increases the speed of your glory kills. Man, do I want that. Like 3 times faster? Hell yeah. Just pummeling dudes like greased lightning. Oh, maybe this is just a secret or a power-up type thing, because I don't think I got this. Praetor, what are they called? Praetor tokens? Yeah. Last time. No, this has got to be the right... No, maybe it's not. I don't know. I stand here just as confused as when I first posed the question to myself, you guys. Typical. Ugh. And yet, I think I missed the objective somehow. Also typical. Can we take a little shortcut here? I don't think I noticed this last time. No, but I think this might go to a secret. Sorry, guys. Bear with me here. I'm curious. Also, enjoy it because, for crying out loud. Enjoy it for now because this episode is actually running a little bit long, but that is okay because we are having a good time. All right, last try, and then I'm not even going to try and get that secret. Or find out what's down this path. Jump! Oh, okay, we made it. is that engineer zombies just hanging off the ledge? Get out of here, guys. There's got to be something cool at the end of this. Come on. Whoa. This place is sweet. This place is totally dope. We got, like, hydroponics going in here. Yeah, I suppose they did, even though they made the Martian atmosphere breathable, they probably still can't grow anything in Martian soil. No. God, I hate these soldiers. They deal so much damage, and the shields are quite effective. And so much, in fact, and since we haven't really done much of it yet, that I think it's time to chainsaw somebody. Just annihilate him. And then get tons of ammo for all our other guns. Alright, so time to judiciously use some rocket launching. Gotta love the rocket launcher. Let's get some full health. I know sometimes I'm using this when I have almost full health already, but it's always worth topping up in a game like this. What is this? More plants. Okay, cool. Yeah, so I didn't come here last time, and I must have missed out on a drone upgrade. All right, so Heat Blast is what I had last time. We're going to try Stun Bomb this time, which is like a grenade launcher type thing, apparently. Let's see how it looks. Oh, that's pretty cool, I guess. Seems kind of wussy, but I bet it does good damage. Hellraiser, that's what they're called. Sorry. The weird beam arm dudes with the crown faces. All right, so we're going to get to right before or right near this last objective, and I think we are going to call it. But as you guys know, that means you probably have like another hour before I end this episode. Come on. All right, so I think we can just, yeah, okay, cool. We can probably just bounce pad up there, take the door. And yeah, so I definitely did. Oh, wait, am I doing it again? I need to go this way. I think I backtracked unnecessarily last time. Like, I think there's an objective I need to clear in here, and then I can leave. Yeah, of course there is. Another one of these. How many of these have I walked right past you guys? I'm so sorry. I'm just in such a killing mode, I don't even notice the objectives. All right, so we have destroyed all chance of there ever being any hell energy on the planet. We are loaded up on ammo, and if you guys want to know what the more of the story is going to happen, well, you'll have to tune in for the next episode. If you guys enjoyed watching, please be sure to like and subscribe and let anybody else who might be into it know. And thank you a lot for watching, and I will talk to you guys next time.